Okay, welcome to the explanation for the card slide I'm naming Full Frontal Control. This is a sort of a bizarre card move, and I do this in my lectures during one phase of an ambitious card routine, and sometimes I'll just use it as a control, and in the right environment, in the right angles, it's really a pretty fooling way to control a card or a group of cards. I'll give you an example. Say I've got the four aces, and I'd like to control the four aces. All I would do is put the aces in the deck, hand the deck to someone or whatever, and the four aces are right back on top of the deck. Let's talk about the mechanics of how this trick actually works. It's based on, I call it full frontal control, because you're using the front of your body in order to control the cards. It's a one-handed control of 1 to 10 cards, I guess you could say. And I got the idea when I was playing around with a Jerry Andrus card control. And a Jerry Andrus pivot kind of move using, you know, two hands sort of thing. And I just noticed one day, almost by accident, that if I would take some cards and put them into the deck and then back, and then secretly angle them and then push them back out of the deck, just basically in jogging a selection, I was doing a routine one day, and one day I brushed my hand against my jacket, and in the act of doing this, here's what happened. Of course, the cards fell on the floor the first time, but when I went like this, the cards pivoted out like that, and of course they fell because I wasn't expecting it, but I realized that if I was expecting it, you could actually get the cards to stay there. So if you have a group of cards, it goes in, angle jogged, and then back jog. So here we are, almost like the in jog riffle force. And then as you do this, your hands naturally move this way, and I just, from here, it's just here to there, and now you're completely covered here, you're completely covered here, your only bad angle is basically right here. Even a person sitting right here can't see, but here's what it looks like right here. The cards are just resting up against my stomach. Now, here's how you get them on top of the deck. The hand just basically comes down. Your thumb grabs those cards as you come forward, and you can even square up if you want to. So again, you can do this as a single card control. Card goes in the deck, the card is back jogged, it's resting against your stomach, and then card handed out. Or you can do it for one card, you can do it for 2 cards, 5 cards, I mean you can do it for a big old thick group of cards, for like a multiple card selection or something. You can put the cards into the deck, come back here, in the rest position, and then even set the cards down for a little while, and then people will, all their members, a group of cards went into the deck, now you've got that same group of cards controlled back to the top of the deck. So I'll do it one more time from this angle so you can actually see how the cards out jog against your stomach area here. Into the center, just like this. Angle, I use my thumb here to push that down, and then my pinky to push this back. That was done slow motion. In normal speed, it happens. In normal speed, I mean, this happens really quick. So the cards are back here. And again, up against your stomach area here, I just press. These cards pop out, held at a perpendicular angle to the deck. And again, these just come and rest as your hand comes back like that. So again, have fun with this. It's a fun little move. There's lots of applications for it. You can use it as a control. If the deck is face up, you can use it as a color change. It's just really something to play with. So if you see me in a lecture do it and you're fooled by it, I've never explained it before on video. So now you have an explanation of what I call the full frontal control. Thanks.